Halo, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome back again in Advanced English Structure class with Miss Siwi. This video, we are going to talk about gerund. As you can see in the slide, here are the things that we are going to discuss about. First thing first, we are going to see the examples of gerunds. As you can see, they are making, sleeping, doing, and eating. So those words are ended by ing. So remember, gerund words are ended by ing. And the next question is, just because they are ended by ing, are they verbs? Well, the answer is no, never. Gerund is always noun. It might look like verb, but actually the gerund words are noun. And just because it is a noun, so in a sentence, gerund word as a subject, or maybe it could be a predicate nominative, or sometime it can become an object, or maybe it can be an object of preposition in a sentence. Okay, before I'm telling you about gerund as a subject, let me recall your memory what subject is. You still remember what a subject is? Subject is who or what a sentence is about. So in this case, a subject is a topic of a sentence. It is always pronoun or noun. So remember, the word class of the subject is always pronoun or noun. So now let's take a look at the example of a sentence. There is that man is my uncle. So can you guess which one is the subject of the sentence? Yes, this sentence has a subject, which is that man. The reasons why that man is the subject because this whole sentence tells about that man. So I'm showing you a sentence with gerund as a subject. So as you can see, we have cooking, the word cooking, and it is a subject of the sentence, yeah, because the sentence talks about cooking. So the topic of the sentence is cooking. But what about if someone writes cook is my hobby? Is this sentence correct? Well, the answer is of course not. Why? Because if you write cook is my hobby, cook, the word cook is a verb. Okay? Meanwhile, in this sentence, the word cooks works as a subject. And a subject must be a noun. To make it as a noun, so we have to change the word cook into a gerund. How? Just add ing. So it becomes cooking. Cooking is my hobby. Remember? Next is predicate nominative. Okay, what is predicate nominative? First thing first, you have to know that predicate nominative is always noun. Remember, the word class of predicate nominative is always noun. Second, predicate nominative works as predicate, as its name. Okay, and the third, predicate nominative renames the subjects. And the last one, predicate nominative always follows a linking verb. Yeah, just because it renames the subject, of course. It always comes after a linking verb. Still remember it, to be, seen, look, and so on. Okay. Okay, now I have a sentence with predicate nominative. Can you guess which one it is? Okay, the sentence, Mr. Walter's daughter is Caroline, has a predicate nominative, and it is Caroline, because the word Caroline renames Mr. Walter's daughter. Next is gerund as a predicate nominative.
Okay, the word drawing in this sentence again is called as a predicate nominative because the word drawing renames the word my hobby. Okay, what about if someone writes my hobby is draw? Is it correct or not? Of course not. Why? Because the word draw in this sentence hasn't become a noun yet. The word draw is a verb. So just because, remember, predicate nominative is always noun, so we have to change the word draw into a noun. How? Just add the ending ing, so it becomes drawing. My hobby is drawing.
An object receives an action that is performed by the subject. And remember, it is always noun or pronoun.
Okay, now let's take a look at this slide. I have two sentences and each sentence has an object. The first sentence is Anne is doing homework and second sentence is Steven bought a new car. Can you guess which one is this object? Exactly. The first sentence object is homework and the second object of the sentence is a new car. So they are called as objects of their sentence. Why? Because the word homework in the first sentence answers what Anna is doing. And the second sentence, a new car, the object of a new car, answers what Stephen bought. And remember that object always comes after a verb. Okay? Speaking of objects, did you know that there are two kinds of objects? They are direct and indirect objects. Okay, I will give you a very simple explanation how to differ direct object from indirect object. Okay, here I have a sentence, Stephen bought a new car. Stephen bought a new car. In the sentence, we have an object, a new car, and it is called as an direct object, is a direct object because the word new car directly receives an action of the verb bought. See, let's take a look at the position, right? The word a new car again directly receives an action of the verb bought. Now, what about if we modify a little bit of the sentence? Now the sentence becomes Stephen bought Karen a new car. Okay, so here we have two objects, Karen and a new car. But still, the word a new car, a direct object in the sentence. And we have an indirect object. Do you remember? We have an indirect object, Karen. Why? Because the word Karen is beneficiary of the action. Someone that has an advantage has got the advantage, yeah, from the action bought a new car. So that's why it is called an indirect object.
Okay, the next question is, do gerunds as an object exist in the sentence? They do. Here I have two sentences with gerunds and both work as an object in the sentence. First, we have I like swimming. We have swimming here as a direct object of the verb like, and we have another swimming in the second sentence, which is an indirect object from the sentence Francisco gives all of his energy and time. So, is it a beneficiary of that activities? Yeah, so it is called as an indirect object. See, those are gerunds. those are nouns, that's why they are ended by a.
The last is object of prepositions. So what is object of preposition? It is a noun or pronoun that comes after a preposition. Okay, now I'm showing you an example of a sentence with an object of preposition. We have the book is on the desk, and which one is the object of the preposition? Here it is, the desk. The word the desk is called as an object of preposition because, take a look, we have a preposition on.
Okay, now let's find out how we use a gerund as an object of preposition. So here I have a sentence, my sister is not interested in swimming. And here I have a gerund swimming in our sentence. Here we go. It is a gerund as an object of preposition. Anybody knows why it is called an object of preposition? Yes, because there is a preposition before the gerund, and. Okay, now time to conclude everything from what you have got. First, gerund is always ended with in, but remember it is never a verb because gerund is always a noun. And just because it is a noun, so it functions as the subject or predicate nominative or something like it becomes an object, or maybe it is an object of preposition in our sentence. And just because of its function, the position of the gerund can be in the front if it is a subject, it can be in the middle if it is a predicate nominative or maybe an object, or maybe it can be in the back if it becomes an object or an object. Okay, those are the things that I can share to you about gerunds in this video. If you still have more questions, feel free to ask please in the classroom. See you again in another video. Stay healthy, stay happy offline. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye.